Thanks, Donna. And hi, everyone. Welcome to the Powerful Devs Conference. This conference is all about showing code-first developers how they can embrace the Power Platform. My name is April Dunham, and I'm a Power Platform advocate here at Microsoft. And I'm so excited to be joined today by Scott Guthrie. He's going to be kicking things off here. We're going to be doing a conversation around the state of the industry and how developers can embrace the Power Platform. Welcome, Scott. Thanks again for joining us for the second year here at the Powerful Devs Conference.
Thanks for having me. It's great to be here.
Awesome. Well, I am really looking forward to this conversation and really diving into that and getting your thoughts and opinions on what the Power Platform has to offer for code first devs. So you ready to get started?
Fire away.
Hey, so first question, kind of coming from me as myself, you know, why I focus on the Power Platform here, I do come from a .NET development background. That's where I really started off. So probably everyone that's watching today that is a code-first developer is wondering, why are we talking about Power Platform and what's in it for the code-first developer?
Yeah, well, I mean, a lot of us, myself included, have come from, I'd say, a code-first background. And to your question of like, why should you care about the Power Platform if you write, object-oriented or procedural code? And I think the biggest reason I'd say is to have even more impact in terms of the applications you build, the solutions you build, and to the companies that you work for or deliver solutions to. And so I kind of think of it in terms of impact and the ability to, leverage the ability of the Power Platform to quickly assemble solutions that can call out to APIs written in .NET or written in Java or any other code-first language and effectively integrate them as part of a business process. And, again, sometimes it's better to write a code API to implement functionality in a business process, but often in the final solution, you want to be able to assemble and connect that API inside a Teams environment or some type of online collaboration tool, with a CRM system or an SAP or a Dynamics ERP solution on the back end. And the beauty of the Power Platform is it makes it incredibly powerful to do that. And at the same time, still integrate and write the .NET and Java code that you know and love today and integrate it all into one solution that makes, your customers happy.
Yeah, definitely. That's a great point. I mean, really, it's just another tool in your tool belt as a code-first developer that you can have and really a productivity and time saver. I know that's how I got started with the Power Platform, saw this thing called Power Automate, figured, hey, I can maybe automate some of my dev tasks in my simple day-to-day. And then I ventured into Power Apps and realized that this can save me a lot of time in front-end development too. So we can still use, the tools that we love and the back-end APIs, but we can just use it to kind of facilitate and make our life a little bit easier. So that kind of leads me though into the next question. So we kind of talked about a little bit of the benefits and why we should care as code-first developers about the Power Platform. But what would you say to those that still might be a little bit hesitant or reluctant to really adopt and use the Power Platform?
Well, I think, I think one of the big things is recognizing it's not do you build an application this way or that way? Meaning like, do you use Power Platform or not? I mean, I think the real way I think about it is it's another tool in your tool chest in the same way that, another framework library is in your tool chest or another DevOps tool might be in your tool chest. And it helps solve very specific problems. It's not, the be all end all that solves every problem in the world. No tool does that. But it can dramatically, I think, help increase the impact that you have. And so I think if you're hesitant, what I'd say is learn more. I think there's a lot there. And once you realize it's not all or nothing and that you can use it to solve very specific needs that are sometimes painful with code to write or certainly time consuming with code to write, I think you'll learn to appreciate it and be able to get even more done from it. And at the end of the day, I think as developers, all of us, want to measure our impact on by, did we change the world? Did we change our company? Did we change end users' success from the applications that we build? And I think the Power Platform is a fantastic way to accelerate all those and really deliver that impact.
Yeah, definitely. Another excellent point there. It's not often an or, it's an and conversation. This is another thing that we can bring to just make our processes and the applications that we build even easier to build. So great point there. You know, this kind of leads me into another topic that I did want to touch on, and that's the topic of the emergence of this concept of fusion development teams. So this is kind of something that's not really new. You know, fusion development's been around a while, but with the emergence of low-code technology like the Power Platform, it's something that we're seeing really an increased adoption of. So these teams are, you know, code-first developers and IT pros and business users and low-code developers working together to solve business problems. So my next question in that would be, how does the Power Platform, Azure, and Visual Studio family of tools really facilitate that cross-employee collaboration that we have in fusion teams to solve business problems?
Yeah, and again, I think this is where it's very much an and, not an or. And so is it, do you use Visual Studio or Power Platform or Azure DevOps or GitHub? You know, it's and, you use them all. And, use which particular tool for a particular problem where that tool works best is kind of the real key. And part of what we try to do is integrate them all together. And so, you know, we've now made it so that you can go into Visual Studio, you can say file new project and create, you know, an API project using .NET Core, write a standard web API, run it locally, debug it, have a nice API calling experience. And then the beauty is you can now publish it into Azure, expose it with an API gateway, you can do metering, you can do authentication, you can do all the things that you want to do in terms of controlling access and monitoring access to that API inside your enterprise. And then you can go with the Power Platform, and with this, you know, two clicks, you can browse all the APIs, subscribe to it, and now build, you know, front-end experiences that are mobile apps or web apps that you can run standalone or, say, hosted inside Microsoft Teams that, again, can run on your phone, they can run on your desktop, all with that integrated security and just all lighting up that functionality. And you can build a simple app in 10 or 15 minutes that does all that end to end. Or maybe instead of a UI app, you want to have automation. And so to your point on the workflow, if I want to build a Power Automate experience, I could say, oh, every time an email arrives, call this API and then update my CRM system. Again, you can do all that in the Power Platform in minutes and take advantage of hundreds of built-in connectors that come out of the box that can integrate with Dynamics or Office or Teams or ServiceNow or SAP or Oracle or any other number of solutions out there. And that beauty of being able to take that kind of declarative, very fast Power Platform experience and at the same time still call your .NET APIs and be able to bridge into very procedural code, it's an and it's incredibly powerful when you put all that together.
Yeah, definitely. We've had, you know, so many improvements and new things with the Titan integration with, you know, Code First, ProDev Tools, and the Power Platform. So I will say to everyone watching who maybe you've used the Power Platform and tried it out like 4 or 5 years ago, it's not the same set of tool set. We've added so much more functionality in there with the integration story from, you know, the Power Platform CLI in the VS Code extension so that we can natively in the tools that we're already using as developers integrate and unpack our Canvas source code and deploy our assets and solutions and all of that. So the integration has really come a long way and has really tightened and made it more seamless for developers to be able to take the tools they're already using and start plug and playing with the Power Platform to automate things. So definitely keep that in mind for all you watching. If you haven't looked at it lately, look at it again because we have a lot of new great features that we've added from the Code First developer side of things. So Scott, this has been great. I do have one more question for you. You know, speaking of these fusion teams and Code First integration with the Power Platform, I know there's no shortage of amazing stories out there of this Code First and Power Platform integration, but what is your favorite story? I'd be curious to hear that you've heard of this developer integration in the Power Platform.
Yeah, I mean, there's a couple. I mean, I think, you know, what's great about, I find for the Power Platform is like, there's a new story every week that the team sends me that, you know, is, you know, often not just a great technology story, but it's a real like business impact story. And, you know, the last 18 months in particular during COVID, you know, I think every organization has had to really adapt quickly and often change business processes, figure out how to work from home, create new security models, create new ways of doing business all on the fly. And, you know, I like that so many of the stories I've heard, you know, speak to the ability of developers in IT to not just get things done for their company, but really be essential to their company. And the companies in some cases wouldn't stay in business without them. And I think, you know, that ability to have impact at a deep business level, you know, means that you as a developer are so much more valuable to the organization you work for. Yeah, a couple of just, you know, examples off the top of my head. You know, Toyota Motor North America, you know, is a giant organization and, you know, delivers and manufactures vehicles and, you know, millions of vehicles across North America. And, you know, they have a whole wide variety of different solutions that they need. And it's, again, going, they need not just to build functionality, but they need really thorough governance processes. They need real support. Tens of thousands of developers, and they built a center of excellence within the organization, and now built more than 400 different Power Apps. And these Power Apps are using not just Power Apps, but the Power Platform, but they're using our Azure AI services, both cognitive services, machine learning, computer vision, our Azure application platform and data platforms, and really stitching all these things together. And so if you're installing components and having to manage travel and safety because of COVID, you know, they were able to create an app for that. You know, if you're doing processes in support of employees that need help with healthcare and other things that are top of mind right now, you know, they built apps for that. If they need to help manage supply chain crises, which, you know, everyone in manufacturing in the world today is having to struggle with, you know, they've built apps for that. And again, that ability to kind of pull all those things together and literally deliver hundreds of apps over the last year that touch every one of their employees' lives and really pull the full power of the Microsoft platform, I think, again, speaks to what's possible. And there's literally thousands of companies or tens of thousands of companies now that can tell that story. And I think, again, to everyone watching here, definitely encourage you to learn, because I think you could tell those same stories about your organization as you learn more about the Power Platform and you start playing around with it and learning what you can do with it, which has really changed the world. And so definitely wish you the best of luck with it.
Yeah, the Toyota story is really great. And I think it kind of shows we've actually got so many great stories coming out of the pandemic. You know, we had to shift gears so fast to accommodate for the changing workforce there and working from home and everything that went along with it. So that really, in a way, gave the Power Platform an opportunity to shine because, you know, customers, all these big customers like Toyota, were able to turn to that and be able to meet a need with something that, you know, traditional code alone might have taken quite a while to be able to adapt to get that. But with the Power Platform, you know, they're saving so much time and being able to build solutions in days rather than weeks or months and be able to meet the needs there from anything like, you know, and we're seeing that again today with trying to get back to work and back in the office and return to work solutions. We have several templates and solutions that are kind of plug and play, ready to use for the Power Platform also to do things like reserving desk and desk reservations and reserving spots in the office to come back safely and all of that. So we've seen a lot of great stories evolve from that. And the Toyota case study as well, one of the things that really interested me was they started using Power Apps heavily for the application development side. And one of the things they were trying to do is surveying facilities. And you notice that they're able to go from about a 5% of dealers surveying to 100% of dealers, which is a huge productivity gain there. So that was something that really stood out to me with Toyota story, just how quickly and how fast they were able to adapt and increase their productivity by embracing tools like Power Apps.
Definitely.
And, yeah. And, you know, so many other great case studies as well that we have there. You know, Coca-Cola bottling is another one that comes to mind. Again, using and integrating with all of the code first technologies that we're used to, like Azure Cognitive Services and AI and Visual Studio and .NET and APIs and custom connectors. Really, the possibilities are endless with what we can do. And you're going to see some of that today as the conference plays out here. We're going to see how we can integrate code in our custom connectors, which is a way that we can take our APIs and services and bring those into the Power Platform solutions that we're building. You'll see things like using Space APIs and creating reusable components with Power Apps Component Framework. So lots of different opportunities and things that we're going to see today for what we can do. This has been such a fun conversation, Scott. Last thing I wanted to ask here for everyone watching, do you have any call to actions for everyone here?
Yeah, well, you know, I know, you know, first of all, I hope you learn more from the conference. And then also, I know there's a lot of people watching that are on Fusion dev teams today and have experience using the Power Platform and doing Fusion development as a team and as a developer. And so it'd be great if you could send us some of your stories. I mean, it'd be great for us to both learn about them, you know, draw and build the product better because of them, and then also share them at other future events and conferences. So definitely send us your stories, and we'd love to hear about them.
Yeah, definitely. And you can just drop those in the chat or even reach out to me on Twitter and let me know. We'd love to hear those stories. And also, if you're watching as well, I want to let you know that we do have a Power Platform developer plan that you can sign up for free to get started today, trying out some of the features of what the Power Platform has to offer. So you can go to aka.ms/PowerAppsDevPlan to get signed up for that free developer plan today and get started with that. Thank you so much for joining us, Scott. It's been a great conversation.
No, thanks so much for having me. And thank you, everyone, for watching. And really appreciate you being here.
Thanks. All right. Back to you, Greg and Donna.